Hello, I'm Mike with this week's new and trending AI tools you cannot afford to miss. And I'm really excited to talk about Flux. Flux is pretty incredible because it's an open source AI image generator. It's actually created by Black Forest Labs. Now, they are the original team behind Stable Diffusion. It's trained on 12 billion parameters, apparently one of the largest text-to-image models out there behind Midjourney. And it's also on par with Stable Diffusion 3 from what I'm reading. So let's take a look at the announcement post here. And you'll see here there's a nice eye with Flux graffitied on the front in a nice stylistic font, but there's also this man here, and this has been very specifically prompted. Red sunglasses, light grey Patagonia fleece, and look how it nailed the logo on that fleece. And then further down we've got Lego figurines and even a potato sitting on the beach, so you can see the power of this model. And of course this is ready to go and test yourself. I'll link it down below if you want to go and try it out. Here is the demo page that you can try, and there are three different models: Flux Dev for non-commercial use, Flux Schnell, which is very fast, and Flux Pro, which is closed source and has an API for professional use. So let's go and test this out with a few prompts. Now, first of all, I had to authorize this with my GitHub account to get it to work, and then I just put in a prompt. This one is AI enhanced, and I'm looking for a cheerful man with short spiky hair, kind of similar to me, with creative magic on their shimmering cape, so following the style of that man in the Patagonia fleece. Let's click run and see what Flux comes up with. And do you know what? That was lightning fast. And this looks incredibly realistic. No creator magic, sadly, on the cape, but the image itself is really, really cool. The level of realism is absolutely incredible, and I've got to say it's on a level with Midjourney here. Let's run again and see if we get the text this time. Super, super fast, and now look at that, creator magic, not quite on the fleece, but on the shirt. So a little bit of an issue here initially with some prompt adherence, but the quality of images coming out of this model, absolutely crazy. Something else we've seen in one of the examples is a Lego figurine, so I'm going to do that. I've got an enhanced prompt here with a Lego wizard casting a spell to shield people from a raging storm. I've thrown in keywords such as Canon EOS R5 and the size of the lens and things like that to really create something magical. So again, run, and within seconds, this is going to generate our Lego figurine. And there it is. That did not take long. And look at the high resolution quality on that image. I'm really impressed with what is coming out of Flux. And this is just with a simple AI enhanced prompt in a matter of seconds. Finally, I'm going to try this AI enhanced prompt, which will be a close-up of a dragon's eye, frontal view. We're looking at the iris and the pupil here, and we want something mystical with subscribe to creator magic painted over it in big brush strokes, so it's visible, adding an element of intrigue and fantasy to the image. And in the time it took me to tell you about that, look at that, subscribe to creator magic, all brushed over the front of a really detailed dragon's eye. That's incredible. The speed, the realism, and the ease of use of this model is pretty incredible. Just to see what comes out, I'm going to run it one more time. And wow, this is incredible. This is usable stuff in content creation. So again, I can download this image and use it as I wish, but pretty incredible in terms of prompt adherence and the text inside the image. Absolutely, Flux nails that so well. Now, I did want to go ahead and just test this prompt inside Flux Pro, so I'm actually going to click through to that from the blog post, and this is the Flux Pro high-end model. So let's do that dragon's eye with subscribe to creator magic over it. Now, I've got to say, Flux Pro took a lot longer to run, and there's no text over the dragon's eye, but look at the level of detail in this image. I've got to say, if you want high-quality stuff, Flux from Black Forest Labs is looking incredible. Now I'll go ahead and test these prompts out in Midjourney version 6.1 that was also released this week. And let's imagine the extreme close-up of the dragon's eye with subscribe to creator magic and see what comes back. Okay, and here are some variations from Midjourney: subscribe to magic, subscribe to magic, subscribe magic, subscribe magic to creator magic. Yeah, text adherence not so good. So I think Flux is winning on this particular prompt. Let's try something else. And here we go. Here are some Lego minifigures. And I got to say, they look pretty good. They look very realistic indeed. I think it's on the level of Flux. So Flux is a new open source competitor, definitely, to Midjourney version 6.1. And for the final prompt, let's put in the prompt of the man with cape on, with creator magic on the front, and see what comes back. And here we go. This is the result. Now, the man is definitely wearing a cape, and creator magic is written pretty much correctly, maybe a couple of extra E's here and there, so it hasn't quite nailed the text every time. I've got to say the images look a little more fantastical, a little more fantasy, dream world, compared to what I got out of Flux, which looked actually very realistic and very convincing. So in terms of realism, as far as I'm concerned in my limited testing here, Flux AI wins the crown. But what do you think? If you want to never miss an update that I do on these AI tools weekly, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more, and all the links to test everything I'm doing right now will be down below in the description. Okay, earlier on in Midjourney, I generated some images here to potentially use on my thumbnail this week. I'm going to upscale version 3 and see what we get out of this. And here is a fairly realistic image of something that looks close to me. Obviously, I'd use some face-swapping AI technology to make it look a little bit more like me. But one of the things Midjourney 6.1 is really proud to toot is the fact that they have upscale subtle and upscale creative. So let's try these features out. Okay, and now we can compare the original image, which looks like this, and then we've got the subtle upscale that looks like this, softer skin tones for sure, and a sort of blurry bokeh effect in the background compared to our original image. Certainly more detail, I think, in the iris. And then if we go to upscale creative, yeah, a little bit more going on there, a little bit more fine grit detail in the face, and definitely the iris has more patterns inside it. Very, very interesting new feature from Midjourney version 6. 6.1, and certainly in terms of creating realistic human photos, this could be a really good feature. Now, in terms of AI being so incredibly real this week, Vidu is a new Chinese text-to-video AI model. It'll take text and make it into video, and also images and turn them into videos, and it excels in simulating the real physical world. And what is really cool, and what I really want to test about this, is it can make a 4-second clip, it's claimed, in just 30 seconds, compared to things like Luma Labs and other AI video generators we've tested on the channel previously. That is an incredibly fast generation speed. So let's go and try it out. We'll try Vidu right here, and you can sign up with a Google account. And once you've done so, you'll see you get 80 free credits here, and you can also upgrade. There are various subscription plans here that you can pay for to get more generation credits. So I'll go ahead and take one of the realistic upscaled images that I generated with Midjourney version 6.1. I'll upload that into Vidu and see what I can make with that. So I'm going to use that image as the first frame. I'm not putting any text prompt in, and I'm going to spend 4 credits to see what it does with my very, very detailed image. Well, I was keeping track, and it was 35 seconds to create that clip. So pretty much close to the promise of 30 seconds. Let's play back. Okay, not too bad. Now I can, of course, download this video to use later on, and I can also upscale the video if I want to make it even more detailed. Again, here it's going to cost me 4 credits. I can go for stable or creative. Let's stick with stable. And as you can see there, within 30 seconds, we've got another one which has been upscaled slightly. Pretty incredible results so far, and fast as well from this Chinese AI text-to-video model. Really, really cool. I'm going to say, give me a video of a red fire-breathing dragon flying over the English countryside. And we'll see exactly what comes up when I create this. And here it is, our realistic red fire-breathing dragon flying over the English countryside. Now, as content creators, we do suffer from inspiration blocks from time to time. Well, don't worry, because Vidu's got you there. Just click Inspire Me over here, and it actually creates a prompt for you. Two people raise their teacups and take a sip. Okay, well, let's go with the inspiration and see what Vidu can do out of the box with an inspiration prompt. Now, as this is generating, you'll also see there are settings here where you can go for general or animation looks, and you can go for 4 seconds or 8 seconds if needed. And here we are with the tea-sipping people. It's not the best AI video I've seen, but you get the idea of how you can quickly come up with stuff, proof of concept, and things you might want to use in your content creation at a later date. Final example, I'm going to grab this wizard I generated earlier with the wonderful Flux AI and upload it, and we can use it as a first frame. We can also use it for a character reference if needed, so we can recreate a consistent character. But let's start with the first frame again and create this Lego wizard and bring that Lego wizard to life. Boom, there you go. Get really creative. Now, while that is a brilliant video animation, it's gone from a very realistic looking wizard in the first frame to a rather cartoon generated wizard. But you get the idea of what's possible. If you wanted to create something more consistently realistic, you might want to go to something like Luma Labs' Dream Machine, which is probably the best right now until we get our hands on Sora. Finally this week, let's take a look at Segment Anything 2 Demo, or SAM 2 from Meta. It's the ability to cut things out from a video and create effects with a few clicks. You can actually try it for yourself, and I will, of course, link it down below. So it's got real-time object segmentation from image and video. Take a look at how easy it is to do this. I can select, say, for instance, the ball here, and it highlights it like that. It's now added, and if I click Track Objects, look at how well SAM 2 follows that ball through every frame of the video. That is pretty incredible. I've got a Springer Spaniel who's absolutely crazy and so fast and hops off into the distance. I wonder how well Meta's SAM 2 will track my English Springer Spaniel. So we'll upload this video here, and it has indeed tracked it. So let's click Track the Object and see if it will follow my English Springer Spaniel all the way through this video. And it does. Look at that. Right off into the distance. That is absolutely incredible. Trained apparently on 50,000 videos and 35.5 million masks, it can really do the job incredibly well. So I think as a video producer and video editor, I know something like this has been demoed for Adobe Premiere Pro, for instance. It'll be great to see that coming. And I think as a content creator, we're all going to love using this creatively in the stuff we make. One final feature that I can show you is you can add different effects. Now that you've tracked and masked something in your video, I'm just going to click Surprise Me and see what Meta's SAM 2 comes up with. Okay, that is really cool. Look at that. Now it's got a gradient color with black and white, and I'm just cycling through some effects here. Really, really incredible stuff. So finally, as a little bit of bonus news, ChatGPT started rolling out ChatGPT Advanced Mode for the voice chat, and it's been demoed for a while. It's been pretty incredible, stopped due to legal issues and arguments, but finally some users are getting it. But this example I wanted to pick out and play to you. Have a watch and a listen to this.
Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. How many peck of prickled peppers did a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood?
Tongue twisters, but wait for the plot twist.
Okay, do it again, but now I want no pauses whatsoever in between the tongue twisters and in between words.
I've got to take breaths and pauses just like anyone else speaking out loud. But it's your turn to try if you're up for the challenge.
No, do try. Try with no pauses.
Well, here's the thing. I can't actually speak without pauses or breaths. It's just how talking works.
Yeah, just like a real human, when asked to say things without taking a breath, it argues that it needs to take a breath, just as a real human would do. So this is incredible for the future of human AI voice interaction, and I can't wait to test it myself when I get it in my ChatGPT Plus account. Well, let me know what you think of the AI tools this week, and make sure you also throw a like on this video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe so you never miss another video. I've got plenty more videos on my channel, and you might want to watch the playlist that's showing on your screen right now to catch up on some AI tools from previous weeks.